You know what I mean?
Even popsicle.
Yeah, you're gonna be a popsicle before too long.
Oh my god.
Better you than me.
And specifically tidewater glaciers that are interacting with the sea, we know that these are the most resilient type of glaciers. They are receiving the most snow and are geographically the best situated to remain healthy glaciers. We also know, thanks to the story of Glacier Bay, that tidewater glaciers undergo a process of slow advance. So, knowing that, we should be able to talk about having advancing glaciers, healthy glaciers that are currently undergoing that slow advance part of the process. But unfortunately, here at Glacier Bend, and thanks to recent satellite imagery, we now know that Marjorie Gibson has lost 350 meters of ice, nearly a quarter of a mile since about 2016. This is not only the case here in Glacier Bay, over 95% of glaciers across Alaska and ice across our globe is melting. And as we know, there is a greater force at work here. There is a greater force that is not only affecting the Glacier Bay and our glaciers, it's affecting your home too. It's affecting ecosystems and weather patterns across the globe. Human-caused climate change is having a huge impact on this place. We are facing these changes every day. So what does climate change mean for our glaciers and the ecosystem here in Glacier Bay?